Hello, my name is Elizabeth, and welcome to the third module of Sustainable Packaging in a Circular Economy. This week we will explore renewable and biodegradable packaging. Last week some of you already mentioned the use of renewable materials as alternatives to plastic. This week we will also see that we can use renewable sources to make plastic. After last week's case study with Coca-Cola, we asked you to share examples of other corporate visions on sustainable packaging. One example introduced Loop, a company who delivers products in reusable containers and picks up empty containers that are washed, refilled, and restocked for another customer. What is outstanding is that Loop is partnering up with global leading retailers such as Tesco, Carrefour, Kroger, Walgreens, and so on. The vision of this company is to create a global reuse ecosystem by partnering up. Another very inspiring example is Amcor, a packaging company, which in contrast to Coca-Cola, is acting on a more global level through worldwide collaborations in order to increase the use and recycling rates. Both examples are approaching a circular economy through collaborations with other companies and organizations. We also saw some great input regarding the separation of different packaging materials. One learner explained her experience with beverage packaging. She separated the packaging by throwing the cardboard layer in the paper bin, the aluminium seal in the metal bin, and lastly the plastic cap in the plastic bin. However, the plastic clamp on it to which the plastic cap fixes on can't be separated from the cardboard. And at the end, it is still not clear if the recycling facility of the city will ensure proper recycling or not. She suggests that the brand needs to inform customers better on how to recycle their packaging. Overall, awareness about separation and collection are recurring themes in this episode, as we will look into renewable and biodegradable packaging. We also have seen insightful submissions on last week's assignment on SketchDrive. One learner made a great analysis about recycling a cardboard container for beverages, which has an aluminium layer inside. Furthermore, we saw some submissions about the recycling of toothpaste packaging. An example was the toothpaste packaging, which is an aluminium tube and a plastic cap. So this makes the separation then easier. If you haven't contributed on the discussion so far, please share an example and comments on other learners' contributions. This course is a great opportunity to learn from each other, so don't miss out on collaborating. We look forward to seeing more of your contributions this week.